All right, so let us start with the database optimizer. So you might have heard this story while I was talking about the database architecture. I mentioned about something called as optimizer, right? So database optimizer, it generates execution plan, right? What is an execution plan? As we already know that there are multiple ways to execute anything or reach to your destination or reach your goal, it depends which path you want to choose because every path has a cost involved. So Oracle, what it does is it will always choose the least cost method or lowest cost method because that's the whole goal of having the database so that you give the response of an SQL query as fast as possible. So you have to choose the plan that is costing you very less. But the main question over here is how the plan is generated and how optimizer will calculate which one is least costing method or plan that optimizer should go for. So what happens is in reality when your database gets an SQL or technically I'm skipping the SQL execution methods. I'm right away getting into the optimizer. So once the SQL comes to the optimizer, what optimizer will do is it will transform the SQL. That's the first step. Transform the SQL. Now you might say, what is this transformation? What happens is every SQL that you run inside the database, definitely one SQL ID will be assigned. So what happens is optimizer will try to see if we transform this SQL, what type of SQL ID is being generated. So if the SQL is exactly same, which has been ran earlier, and after transforming the SQL, the SQL ID is same as some previous SQL ID, then what it will do is it need not generate a new execution plan. So every SQL ID will have an execution plan attached. So what optimizer will do is it will transform the SQL, it will create the SQL ID, and then it will check whether that SQL ID was ran already in the database. If the same SQL ID was ran, it will pick up the execution plan because already the execution plan has been generated, right? So it's better to pick up the already generated execution plan and then run that directly, run the query with this execution plan. Now, this might create a problem, okay? Why? Because the execution plan that was generated earlier, at that point of time, the table had 100,000 records. But now 50% of the records are deleted and we have only 50,000 records. So this creates a problem, or the records are increased or decreased. So this execution plan that was generated earlier, it had different statistics about the table. But the new, of course, Oracle, if it is picking up the old execution plan, and if there is a huge data change, that might be a poor execution plan. All right. So how do you change it and all is a completely different concept, but our goal is to understand about the optimizer. So the first step that optimizer does is to transform the SQL, see how SQL ID is, if that SQL ID is already ran. And then after this, what it something that runs inside the optimizer is estimates. These estimates will kind of like they tend to look at the exact statistics of the data, like number of records inside the database and number of tables owned by the schema and other stuff. So for now, I'll only write estimates would be equal to stats. Stats exactly related to your table, like how many records and all inside the table. And then finally, after looking at these two, is when the optimizer generates the plan. This is how things works inside the optimizer. So the job of the optimizer is to look at the stats inside the database. Now the question is, from where these stats come into picture? It's simple, your base tables. Because all your base tables, they know everything about your database. What is, how many tables, how many records, which table space, everything. They know everything about your entire database. So what optimizer will do is it will pick up all the necessary statistics about the database. Then it will generate a plan. Now, this is where the problem lies in. Remember, I mentioned if a table had 100,000 records and a user deleted 50% of them, but the statistics are not updated. This is also a challenge inside the database. Your base tables say that you have 100,000 records on the table, but your table on physical, it is having 50,000 records. That means this is feeding wrong stats to the optimizer, and optimizer will generate a wrong or a poor performing plan. So this is just an overview of optimizer, guys, and there are a lot of stuff that goes into the optimizer. Any specific doubts with the optimizer, guys? And this is just an overview because there are a lot of stuff inside the optimizer. Looks like most of you are trying to digest this stuff. All right. So this all might be new to you. That's perfectly okay. Or if you already know, that's great. But performance tuning again, yeah.
Arun, can you explain that transform the SQL once again?
Very simple. One query, like you are executing a query, it will generate a SQL ID. And that SQL ID, optimizer will check whether it was already executed. And if it is already executed, there will definitely be a plan attached to it. So optimizer will use that plan. It will not go for statistics and regenerating a plan. So you are saving two steps over here, right? So that's the benefit of transforming the SQL.
But from where the ID, so SQL ID comes in, how does that optimizer allocate SQL ID to that SQL statement?
Don't worry, while we are doing the practicals, you will understand in the SQL, when we are using SQL tuning optimizer, you will see how to find the SQL ID, from where the SQL ID comes in, what SQL text is attached to the SQL ID, what SQL plan is attached to it, you will see it.
Thank you.
Right.